Disinfectants vary in terms of their effectiveness, as well as their potential environmental and health impacts. Schools should work with their distributors to choose the safest and most appropriate products for their school environment. Designated school staff can usually select from a range of EPA-registered disinfectants for use in the school. In certain circumstances, EPA-registered chlorine bleach may be required by local public health laws or may be considered by your school to be the most effective product available. Chlorine bleach, sometimes called household bleach or sodium hypochlorite, is used in many schools today. However, as with all chemical products, when using chlorine bleach, there may be human and environmental health considerations. Chlorine bleach must be handled safely and used only by trained staff who wear proper personal protective equipment and who keep in mind the health of themselves and all building and school bus occupants. Whenever possible, routine disinfecting with chlorine bleach should be done after school hours when students and staff are not around and in well-ventilated spaces. In case of an infectious disease outbreak, refer to your ICP, school officials, and your local health department for disinfection guidance. Chlorine bleach should always be properly labeled, stored, and kept separate from incompatible chemical products. See the safety data sheet for complete information. Chlorine bleach is corrosive and can release dangerous gases if mixed with incompatible products. Never mix chlorine bleach with ammonia, acids, or any other cleaning products. When mixing chlorine bleach solution, trained staff should use proper PPE and avoid contact with eyes, skin, and clothing. They should ensure that the area is well lit and well ventilated with enough room to perform the task. They should check the shelf life of the chlorine bleach to ensure the effectiveness of the product. If possible, trained staff should mix the product in a basin or wash sink. Based on the product's concentration, they should follow the directions for mixing the concentrate with water. Once applied to a surface, the staff should be sure to allow for the right surface contact time, which is the length of time the solution must remain wet on the surface to be effective. Trained staff should carefully prepare the solution by pouring the proper amount of cool water into an empty container first, and then add the proper amount of chlorine bleach to the water. This helps reduce the release of vapors and avoid splashing bleach. Do not use more than the recommended amount of chlorine bleach. After the solution is prepared, trained staff should select an opaque storage bottle and never use a bottle that was previously used to contain a different product. Clearly label the dispenser bottle with the name of the product, its concentration, and the date of preparation. Finally, clean up the preparation area by washing any measuring devices used, removing PPE and disposing of gloves, and thoroughly washing your hands. When using a chlorine bleach solution, be sure to follow your school's infection control plan, ICP, wear the proper PPE, read the manufacturer's instructions and the safety data sheets for the product to be aware of any potential hazards and how to use the product safely. If possible, apply only when students and staff are not present. Make sure you are using fresh product. Like some other disinfectants, chlorine bleach solutions lose strength over time, so the diluted product should be used within 24 hours. Always begin by first cleaning a surface. Apply the chlorine bleach solution after cleaning. If using a spray bottle, adjust the setting to produce a heavy spray instead of a fine mist. Apply the product to the surface and let sit for the required contact time found on the product label. For some concentrations of bleach solution, if a disinfected surface will later be touched by skin or is a food contact area, it is important to rinse the surface with water after the contact time is up. Allow the surfaces to dry completely. Once the surfaces are completely dry, students and staff may be allowed back into the area. After disinfecting, carefully remove all PPE, wash hands with soap and water, and dry them. Chlorine bleach solutions of all concentrations should be stored in a secure area that is not accessible to children. Store solutions below eye level to prevent spilling into your eyes when being moved. Never store chlorine bleach above other products. Accidental leaks or spills could cause bleach to come in contact with an incompatible substance and could result in a dangerous chemical reaction. Always store chlorine bleach on the lowest shelf possible. Make sure chlorine bleach is stored away from incompatible products, including acids, ammonia, and other cleaning products. And carefully place containers to reduce the chance of spills. When disposing of chlorine bleach, wear the appropriate personal protective equipment. Under some circumstances, and depending on your state's requirements, concentrated chlorine bleach and diluted bleach solution should be disposed of differently. Manufacturers' chlorine bleach products, if unusable, must be disposed of as hazardous waste if the pH of the product is greater than 12.5. Chlorine bleach solutions, because they have been diluted, can be disposed of down the drain after 24 hours of mixing. Chlorine bleach can be an effective tool in helping to prevent the spread of infectious disease in schools. But like many products that are effective against disease-causing germs, exposure to chlorine bleach can also have potential environmental and health impacts. Therefore, proper training in the mixing, use, and disposal of chlorine bleach solutions is critical to maintaining a safe and healthy school environment.